In this tutorial, I'll show you how to set up and install your very own data pack. This is the first tutorial I've seen that uses a very useful new extension for Visual Studio Code that makes data pack creation far easier than it's ever been before. So come with me as we jump through the basic hoops necessary to get your data pack up and running. Question for the audience. Why use a data pack instead of, you know, command blocks? Command blocks seem awfully nice. You put a command into them, and it runs them, either when activated or every tick. Isn't that awfully simple? Well, the main issue is that command blocks are inextricably tied to the corporeal plane. They're blocks. The issue with blocks is that... Anyway, data packs are saved within the world file, in a separate directory called... data packs. Data packs can contain functions, which do everything command blocks do, but better, faster, and easier. Now that you understand the premise here, and why it's extremely important that you learn how to make data packs immediately, let's start with the most essential tool of the trade. Microsoft Notepad. I'm kidding. A true servant of the people made a data pack syntax highlighter for Visual Studio Code. So that's what we're gonna use. Step one. Download and install Visual Studio Code. You can get it here at code.visualstudio.com. Or by typing Visual Studio Code into Google. Smack the big download button. Don't worry too much about the settings in the installer. Unfortunately, there's no official data pack support from Microsoft. Once you've got that installed, we can head over to step two. Step two. This is the main point of this video. Datapack Helper Plus is the first actually good tool I've ever seen for datapack creation. It gives us something akin to autocorrect for Minecraft commands. It is unbelievably useful. Anyway, go to this page, link in the description again, and click on install. It should ask if you want to allow the page to run Visual Studio Code, and of course you do, click OK. They also recommend using the syntax highlighting extension to make it easier to read. I also recommend it. Great. That's all the installation we have to do. Now on to step three. Step three. Step three. Make a world. Here I'll make a new void world. I go more world options, world type superflat, click on customize, presets, and pick void world. This preset gives us a nice cobblestone platform at the cost of the absolute worst color grass in the entire game. Let's prevent that and change the biome to forest by replacing Minecraft colon the void with Minecraft colon forest. Nice. Now just set a block somewhere. I'll do slash set block 0640 stone. This gives us a stone block at the coordinates 0640. Oh, and if you forgot to set your game mode to creative mode, it's best to just give up now, because you will be stuck in an endless void, falling to your death forever. Step 4. Now that our world is set up, open Visual Studio Code. You should have something that looks similar to this. The first thing we have to do is find our datapack folder. Click on Open Folder, not Open File, or go to File, Open Folder. To find your .minecraft folder from here, click in an empty part of the top bar and type %appdata%. Now open .minecraft, find saves by pressing S to select the first file that starts with the letter S. Now sort by date modified and open your world. There should be a folder here called datapacks. Open it, and now, finally, create a new folder for your datapack. Right click, New Folder, and name it whatever you want. I'll call this one Tutorial. Infinite creativity on display here. Now either select it or open it and hit Select Folder in the bottom right. If everything worked, you should now have a small empty folder on the left. Here's mine, called Tutorial. Okay, looking good. Next, we have to set up the contents of the data pack. First, create a file by clicking the Create File button. Call it pack.mcmeta. It's very important that you type it exactly like this. This file tells Minecraft what version your data pack is made for and lets you write a description for it. Okay, here's how to write this file. First, an open curly bracket, then in quotes, pack, colon, then another pair of curly brackets, and then, quote, pack underscore format, end quote, colon, 6, and then a comma, make a new line, and then write description in quotes, a colon, and then you can write in quotes whatever you want your description to be. I'll write example data pack. Then just make sure you closed off the curly brackets and there's absolutely no mistakes, or you could just copy and paste it from the description. Up to you. Also, a quick note about pack format. This number goes up every time data packs get a significant update. As of 1.16.2, the latest pack format is 6. If you want to know the most up-to-date information, you can go to the Minecraft Wiki page on data packs and... Oh, come on! They got this one wrong, too! Now we can start getting into the good stuff. Create a new folder and call it whatever you like. You know how everything in vanilla is prefixed with Minecraft? Like Minecraft colon stone for stone, Minecraft forest for forest biomes. This is called a namespace. The name of this folder will be the namespace for your data pack, and everything in your data pack will be prefixed by the name of this folder. Create your folder and call it something short and unique. You can actually create as many namespaces as you want, but they all have to be stored within a folder called data. So in your master folder, create a folder called data. Move your namespace in there. It'll ask you if you want to confirm, and you say move. Now inside your namespace, there are a lot of different types of files we can create. This tutorial will only be covering the objectively best part, functions. So create a folder called functions. Inside this folder, we can finally create some functions. Create two new files called tick.mcfunction and load.mcfunction. Tick will be called every tick, just like a repeating command block. And load will be called once when you open the world or reload the data pack. Before we write anything in these, we need to tell the game that they exist. So click on the original data folder and create a new folder called Minecraft. Then inside that folder, create a folder called tags. Then inside that folder, create a new folder called functions. Now create two files in this folder called tick.json and load.json. Now it's giving us an error because we have nothing written in these files. Write in text exactly like this, except replace the namespace tutorial with whatever your namespace was. Go ahead and pause the video, the text will be in the description so you can copy and paste it. Okay, have you done it in both the files? Make sure tick.json has your tick function and load.json has your load function. Step five, Nully, we can write some code. Okay, we're all done with these two .json files. You can close them now and open up load.mcfunction. Now you can write your beautiful load message with a giant ASCII art of a dog that takes up the entire chat. Or you could not. Just think about it. Okay, we can write a little load message. For educational purposes. An MC function file is just a long list of commands that all get run in order whenever this function is called. The reason we're using Visual Studio Code to write this is that they make writing these commands much easier. Check it out. I want a message to display when my data pack loads, so I'll write, with no slash, tell raw at a, look how it's highlighting it. I type an open curly bracket, and then if I hit Control or Command space, a list of things that I can put here just pops up. So I'm gonna pick text, and it puts our cursor right where we can type. So I'll type, my code is load. Now I wanna add a color, so move out of the quotes, type a comma to split up the tags, and then start typing color, and bam, it's already there. So I'm gonna type hashtag 0000FF. This will give me pure blue, because as of Minecraft 1.16, we can have text in any color. Truly the greatest change since boat physics. To see our beautiful load message, go into your world and type slash reload. There it is. No need to open and close the world, just use the slash reload command to reload your data packs. You know, let's go off script a little bit here. I'd like to give you a fun example of what functions can really do. I'll show you how to make a very simple example. I'll create a new function in my functions folder called sheep.mcfunction. In it, I'll write execute at s run summon sheep. And then... now if I type slash reload, and then... it's beautiful! To summon all those sheep, I used the slash execute command. Oh look, there's a tutorial for it! If you only watched to the end of this video for my incredible, legit personality, why not check out this video where I make fun of the redstone in a not-so-scary horror map with Boolin Brennan? Or you could just disappear into the void like the rest of them. Up to you.